Hello and welcome to Toy Teardown. Today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. Instead of destroying a toy, we're going to be fixing a toy. And even cooler, this toy was actually sent in to us. And it's super old. Like 80's big hair old. It's ALF! Now, ALF was the star of a TV show in the 80s. He is an alien from outer space that crash lands into a suburban family household, causing a fair bit of mischief. He's constantly cracking jokes at the family's expense, as well as casually trying to eat the household cat.
Where do you keep your casserole dishes?
Why?
The cat won't fit in the toaster.
So ALF is actually supposed to talk. You're supposed to press a button and he says things, but he hasn't been working in years.
It's broken.
So let's open him up and see what's wrong. You cool with that, ALF? Yeah, he's cool with that. Really enjoying playing with his hair. So ALF is actually a collector's item, so I've got to be really, really careful pulling him apart. It's got to be quite a delicate operation, I think. Okay, I can feel there's like some kind of thing inside. So, oh. That was easy. Sorry. That's just like a tiny little pouch. Look at that. Got this thing inside. Is there anything else in there? Nope. Okay, so first step done. We've pulled out his speaker or voice box, and that was way easier than some other toys I've dealt with. Oh, what's that? Oh. All right, so now that we've got this voice box out, let's pull it apart. So you can see a speaker and this button here and a couple of screws. So let's take them out. See what's inside. Wow, that is so cool. First thing I'm confused about is the fact that it's got a DC motor, which actually looks exactly like other DC motors in other toys that I've pulled apart. Check out our video on DC motors. And this bit here looks like a speaker. And I don't know what that is, but I guess we'll find out. What I'll do is I'm going to pull off this back bit as well. I've just taken the batteries out for now. What? This is so cool. Okay, so it's a tiny little vinyl record player. Look at that. That is awesome. All right, so I wonder how. Okay, so I can see the little needle there and everything. Okay, that makes total sense actually, because I guess in the 1980s, you didn't have MP3s or anything like that. It was all vinyl records or cassette tapes. So I guess that kind of makes sense as to why this toy has a vinyl record inside. That is so cool. Why isn't it working? I think what we're gonna have to do is have a bit of a think about how vinyl record players actually work and a bit about sound. So let's do that.
Right now, you're hearing my voice through technology, like a computer or a phone.
That sound is a digital signal, zeros and ones.
That digital signal is then converted into an analogue signal as sound waves that you can hear and sent out through speakers or headphones. That's basically how MP3s, Spotify and CDs work. Hey!
Sound itself is actually an analogue signal and it moves through the air as waves. Every sound has its own unique sound wave, like my voice or this guitar.
You would have called first.
Well, I had the music pretty loud. I probably wouldn't have heard the phone.
What's really cool is you can take that sound wave and turn it into a physical thing, which is exactly what a vinyl record is. Vinyl records have tiny microscopic grooves in them, which are the exact same shape as the sound wave itself. And when you play back a vinyl record, the needle travels along all of those tiny grooves that are etched into the vinyl, up the tone arm, out the speakers, and they reproduce the exact same sound etched into the vinyl. Pretty groovy. As far as record players go, they're pretty simple. All you need is a platter for the record to sit on, a motor to spin the record, something attached from the motor to the platter to spin it, and then the needle to feel the grooves. Pretty simple. So now that we know how sound and record players work, I think we can go back and fix ALF. Let's do this. So now that we know a little bit about how record players work, let's see how it works in this toy. So I'm just gonna pull this, whoop, oh dear. I'm gonna pull this guy off so we can look at our voice box a little bit closer. Gently pull the speaker off. There it is. So the first thing I'm gonna do is just look at the circuit and see if there's any very obvious breaks. So if the circuit's broken in any places, electricity won't be able to flow through. So here, let's have a look. So this is our battery. Goes from there all the way down. We have these two parts here, which touch, and then that goes back up to the motor, back out again, and then back to the other side of the battery. So I can't see any major breaks there. I think the second part, the second thing I'm gonna do is just check that this motor works. Okay, so get some batteries and let's see if our motor works. Yep, it works. Okay, that's a good thing. So our motor works. There's no break in the circuit that I can see. It could be maybe a little bit grubby. So there might be, I might need to clean. Being an old toy, gets lots of like dust and stuff in it. So, but I think. So I've just realized that there's this lackey band here around the platter, which turns the record, and that needs to be connected to the motor, otherwise it's not going to turn the record. I think that'd help. So let's see if I can just reattach that and maybe it'll work. All right, so all I have to do is get this around the motor. Let's try it again. All right, I think that's stuck. Put this guy back on. I'm gonna chuck in the battery and see if that worked. No problem. That worked. Awesome. What else does he say?
No problem.
Okay.
No problem. You're out of this world.
That's awesome. You're out of this world. What else? Okay, no problem. Okay, he seems to say no problem a lot. I think he's just really stoked that I fixed him. How good was that? That is actually super awesome that this toy from like 35 years ago was pretty easily fixed. Using something as simple as a lackey band. I mean, I think potentially it could have been a jammed motor as well, and us just kind of jiggling it around might have helped that as well, but.
I'm a people alien.
You're a people alien! Yay! Let's put it back in. Ready?
I'm a people alien.
Yay!
A whisker for your thoughts.
A whisker for your thoughts? What else?
You're a kitty, kitty, kitty.
No eating cats. Not today. ALF? That was so awesome. I honestly can't believe that little ALF had a tiny little vinyl record player inside. It's just got me thinking about what other toys might be out there with really cool, maybe old technology inside. If you know of any, just pop them down in the comments and maybe we can pull that apart. I think it's about time I got ALF back to his owner, but before that, make sure you like, subscribe, let us know what you thought about this episode. Until next time, bye!
How about a hug for the old alpha?
You can have a hug.
You are no longer a cat. You are a bagel.